It's June 2008, and this is the west corner of Block H. Now, there's a lot of question marks about this part of the trench. We're not sure how deep the archaeological deposits are in this area. If there are waterlogged deposits here, because the depth of deposits is very deep, then we're liable to have a lot of organic material on site as well. So what we're going to do is to excavate a deep trench in this corner to give us some idea about the character of the deposits and the site. Now, as part of the operation, we need to do an initial plan of the trench. We've got, as well as Haver Lane to record, we've also got remains of the 19th century buildings, which are on one side of Haver Lane, that will be affected by the excavation here. So we're going to do a composite plan of the entire trench. So everything that's going to be excavated initially by the machine down to the bottom of the 19th century levels is being recorded now. So it's 23rd of June 2008, and we're beginning the excavation of the deep trench at the western corner of Block H. First of all though, we've got to take off the 19th and 20th century structural remains, so we're doing that by machine, and eventually we'll get down to the archaeological deposits that have to be dug by hand, and that's when the machining will stop. The machine's changed buckets. It's now got a toothless ditching bucket on. That's so that it can excavate material, but it's not going to leave grooves in the ground that the teeth buckets do. So if there are any archaeological deposits there, it's easier to spot because you've got a nice even surface. Barry, that's great. Stay at that level. Yeah, and just clean back on that bit as well. Now, strictly speaking, a metre in, because we'll need everything we can get, is actually there, just about where my foot is. Yeah. This is where it gets a bit tricky, because obviously we don't want to undermine that. Now, this deep trench isn't going to have any shoring, so we're going to step the trench in as we go down to prevent the trench from collapsing in on us. So you can see on this side, that's the edge of the trench. Goes down a metre and then it steps in a metre, and we're beginning to excavate the next metre down. And when we get down a metre in here, we'll step in again and go down another metre until we get to the bottom, and so on.
Well, you join us at quite an interesting part of the excavation process. We're finding some quite interesting things. We've been taking out this big old 19th, 20th century wall which comes around here, and we found it's got an absolutely huge construction cut. It's very wide at the base, it's very, very substantial, but in the section revealed by the construction cut, we're getting a lovely sequence of deposits. So you've got Haver Lane situated up here, which has been disturbed here by 20th century activity, the makeup for Haver Lane just showing, and below here, kind of silty layer, a green glazed medieval pottery out of that. Further down, it's getting much more looking like occupation deposits, a very dark burn layer here. We've had lots of animal bone refuse, and even just down the way, a small silver coin. So it's bodes quite well. Over here, we have several different layers of demolition, and we have noticed that they have distinctly different types and dates of brick within them. So clearly we've got a sequence of building, demolition, which as we clean up the site, we'll have to pick apart and work out a nice timeline for.